Item number, SCP-493. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. Instances of SCP-493 are to be kept in separate standard personnel-grade rooms with basic furnishings for a human-like SCP. Individual SCP-493 may request additional furnishings, provided the request does not violate restrictions specific to that individual. Additions must be approved on a case-by-case basis by Level 4 personnel. SCP-493-2 and SCP-493-3 have been allowed to continue their work as Level 2 personnel. However, they are not to be assigned to high-risk areas, in order to prevent premature duplication. Each instance of SCP-493 is to be marked with a tattoo of their designation number on their upper right arm, to prevent any confusion between the otherwise similar appearance of each individual. Description: SCP-493 is a group of genetically identical males of apparent ages between 20 and 90 years old. The younger SCP-493s have brown hair and brown eyes, are about 1.7 meters tall, and weigh between 70 and 90 kilograms, depending on diet and activity. Older SCP-493's hair turns gray after beginning to bald around an apparent age of 50 years old. Each SCP-493 currently in containment is fluent in English and multiple dialects of German, speaking with a moderate Swiss-German accent. SCP-493-7 and SCP-493-8 are also fluent in Spanish. 7 instances of SCP-493 are currently in containment. From estimated duplication rates, it is believed that a minimum of 12 instances of SCP-493 have not yet been contained. When an instance of SCP-493 dies, nothing abnormal presents itself immediately. The corpse will decompose naturally. However, approximately 3 hours after death, 2 younger SCP-493s, appearing to be in their early 20s, will materialize in close proximity to the location of death. These 2 new instances of SCP-493 are identical to each other and maintain the memories of all of their previous lives. Other than the memories of their previous life, individual instances of SCP-493 do not appear to share any sort of mental link or bond with each other after reconstitution. If the 2 young SCP-493s move away from each other geographically, they may lead completely separate lives. Addendum: SCP-493-1 came to the SCP Foundation in 1963 as a Level 1 researcher 4 years before it was known that he had unique attributes. On April 1967, shortly after being given Level 2 access, SCP-493-1 was killed during a containment breach of SCP at Site 19. His remains were dealt with according to standard procedure for all Level 2 personnel. 3 hours and 2 minutes after SCP-493-1's death, several Class D personnel involved in the cleanup reported a thin mist appeared in 2 vaguely humanoid shapes in the corridor outside SCP-493's containment chamber. Approximately half a minute later, a bright flash followed. As the flash subsided, 2 naked human males, SCP-493-2 and SCP-493-3, were standing in place of the mist. The pair were immediately placed in containment, and then questioned. SCP-493-2 and SCP-493-3 have divulged their origins, the accuracy of which has largely been confirmed by historical and dental records. The original SCP-493 was born in 16 in Zurich, Switzerland, becoming a successful Protestant pastor before his first death and subsequent reconstitution in 17. SCP-493-2 and SCP-493-3 claim the recent events involving SCP resulted in their 5th reconstitution to date. Details of SCP-493-1's family tree of reconstitution can be found in Document 493-H. Containment of free SCP-493 is a work in progress. It is the Foundation's hope that the majority of SCP-493 can be contained before duplication of SCP-493 runs exponentially out of control. However, just rounding these subjects up is quite the task. It's not like we can just put a bulletin up when the people we need to find could be any age. Dr. It is unknown if SCP-493 will keep dividing with every death, but there is no reason to doubt such an occurrence. Permanent containment and termination options are currently under consideration. Update 493-1. Agent apprehended SCP-493-4 and SCP-493-5 in Germany on December 1967. Each appears to be approximately 40 years old, the same age as SCP-493-1 before death. Update 493-2. On February 1976, SCP-493-6 is discovered homeless on the streets of New York City, appears to be about 30 years of age. Incident Report 493-A. SCP-493-6 commits suicide. Data expunged. SCP-493-7 and SCP-493-8 are to be kept under close observation in quarters, guarded against future suicide attempts. Update 493-3. Following several heated arguments over the current political and religious status in various major nations, SCP-493-2 and SCP-493-3 have requested to be removed from duty in sectors surrounding and including containment chamber of SCP-493-5. Request denied. You're professionals. Start acting like it. Dr. Update 493-4. SCP-493-2 and SCP-493-3 have repeated requests to be removed from SCP-493-5, stating that Regulation 36 Subsection 8A states that they are not permitted to oversee contained family members without sufficient supervision, and arguing that this regulation applies to their case. Request granted by Dr. SCP-493-2 and SCP-493-3 are denied access to all other SCP-493s. And I am sick and tired of them heaping extra paperwork on me by quoting obscure regulations that I didn't even know about. Dr. Update 493-5. SCP-493-4 dies after complications following a fall and a broken hip. Well, that was one of my more unpleasant deaths. SCP-493-9, shortly after reconstitution. Memo 493-BA. Request by Dr. to show him what an unpleasant death is. Denied. No, I don't care that he'll survive it. We don't need even more of these things running around. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-492, Animated Cloth Dummy, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.